Prosecutors from the state of Florida rested its case in the Nicholas Cruz sentencing trial after the jurors visited the school in Parkland Thursday morning, seen here from Miami Herald's video, where 17 people died in the 2018 mass shooting.
Attention all units in District 15, possible shots fired at 5901 Pine Island Road at Stoneman Douglas High School.
Cruz, now 23 years old, already pleaded guilty to shooting 34 people, killing 17 and injuring 17 others on that early February morning 4 years ago. Among those killed was 16-year-old Filipino-American Carmen Shentrop.
She was very academically rigorous, spent a lot of her time studying and preparing to go to a college of her dreams. She was also someone who very much was, you know, coming into her own and better understanding herself as a person. She was someone who always really enjoyed pop culture, specifically around a comic book.
Carmen's brother, Robert, tells ABS-CBN News he's not watching or following the trial.
I am also not particularly curious about what is going on. I know that for myself and for my process of healing, I don't see the trial really being a part of that. And so it's not something that I'm really engaged with.
The sentencing trial is for the jury to decide whether Cruz should get the death penalty or life in prison. Shentrop, who now works with the youth-led program advocating gun violence prevention, does not believe Cruz should be put to death.
I do not believe that the answer to murdering someone, right, us as a culture saying you murdered someone, an act so heinous, that the only thing we can do is also murder you, for me, I don't see how that connects. Because if murder is so bad, then why are we as a state, as a society, doing it?
But his parents disagree. In a tweet, April Shentrop partly says if police did their job that day, the shooter would have been killed. Since they didn't do what was needed then, let the court get it right this time. Carmen's murderer deserves the death penalty.
I don't find him getting a life sentence particularly satisfying. What for me will be justice and accountability is fixing the systems that allow this to happen so that it cannot happen again.
Shentrop believes a series of failures led to this tragedy.
I see the gunman as a symptom of many broken systems or many things that failed him in his life that led him to the situation in which Parkland occurred. He was someone who needed severe help and never received it.
Although Shentrop is not following the trial, he tells us he can't help but feel anxious, especially for his parents.
I am, of course, worried, about when the verdict comes out, how that will affect them, about kind of the level of how much of a stake this trial has in their healing from what happened, in their search for accountability and justice. And so when that is over, when the trial is over, I hope that it aids them in that journey. Of course, I am fearful that it will move things backwards.
The sentencing trial, which began on July 18, is expected to last a few more weeks, with the defense calling its own set of witnesses. Lenn Alamdin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.